Hi, I'm Alex McRickard, and this is the Fishing Report for the month of June in Virginia. In this month's report, we're going to highlight our new Fish Local Virginia program. We're going to hear from regional fisheries biologist Scott Herman, who's going to highlight some of the recent habitat improvement work that we've done on our fish local waters across the state. We're also going to break down some introductory fishing equipment and some basic rigs and lures for beginner anglers to have success on our fish local waters. Let me take a brief moment to congratulate lucky angler Niles Huber on this great catch of a largemouth bass in downtown Richmond. Niles and his father recently spent a day paddling on the James River below 14th Street and caught this fantastic largemouth bass. Congratulations again, Niall. If you're interested in having your fish featured in a future fishing report, email us at social@dwr.virginia.gov. We have over 80 bodies of water in our Fish Local Virginia program. And this program is really aimed at creating exceptional angling opportunities near urban metropolitan areas. You don't always have to travel far to find good fishing. And oftentimes on these impoundments, we stock them with largemouth bass, channel catfish, a variety of sunfish species, and even trout during the cold weather months of the year on some of our fish local impoundments. In addition to stocking, we also provide exceptional habitat improvement projects on these bodies of water. Scott, do you want to tell us about some of the habitat improvement work that we've recently done out here on some of these waters?
Yeah, we're out here at Three Lakes Park, Lake Number One. It's in a part of northern Henrico County, part of the Henrico County Park System. Great opportunity for people to fish out here living within Henrico County in Richmond. Some of the habitat we've done over the last year and a half or so, we sank about 150 Christmas trees. You got different reef piles of trees. And just recently, last Thursday, we were out here sinking mossback fish habitat structures. We went with the root wad kit structures, which is basically a three-pipe design with a lot of interconnecting leaves that go through. And you have a top surface mat, protects, provides shade cover, allows fish to kind of come inside of the pipe structures, finding some of that overhanging shade cover, which is good, especially out here on hot sunny days. But, you know, it provides a lot of that good cover that, you know, a lot of the smaller fish will come into those structures and maybe have some of the larger fish kind of orientating just around the outside edges of those. And, you know, you might have some decent fishing opportunities. They were just put in Thursday, so sometimes it takes a little bit of time for those fish to kind of figure out what these new structures are.
And some of these structures, Scott, you've put in areas that are really close to access from the bank. So bank anglers can easily cast and target these fish habitat structures if they choose to.
Yeah, we were able to, you know, put them within easy casting range, even for young anglers. A lot of the times you don't want to put it too far away from the bank. You know, out here it's all shorebound fishing. There's no boat access or no boat use here at the Henrico County Park Lakes. So it's just kind of one of those things where you want to have it within easy reach of anglers. So get a nice cast along the sides, maybe on top, and just kind of see where the fish are holding on some of these structures.
So Scott, you actually sample Three Lakes on an annual basis.
Yeah, we get out here, do electrofishing surveys. It's surprising how many nice fish are out here at Three Lakes Park. We've seen some bass, you know, 5.5 pound range. A lot of those larger fish are kind of keying in on the gizzard shad population, as well as the abundant bluegill forage base that's out here. We saw some decent fish this past spring, you know, in the 2 to 4 pound range. Didn't see those 5, 5.5, but that's not to say that they weren't hiding in some of the overhanging shoreline cover.
Decent little bass out here on Three Lakes on the swim bait here. Poke that out. Decent little fish. Sometimes you can do decent casting around some of the overhanging limbs and some of the bank structure, but this is a little largemouth. We'll let this guy go here.
We're at Three Lakes Park showing off a display of some of the basic fishing tackle, some of the rigs that you can use if you're just getting into fishing. Fishing can be complicated if you go to Bass Pro Shops or Green Shops, thousands of different lures. But basically, if you come out here, all you need is a few lures in your, you know, small tackle box, get you going, and it sets you in the right direction as to, like, you know, hopefully catch some decent fish. One of the things you can come out here, if you got a top water plug here, definitely nice and easy on some of these shallower flats here, work of that, kind of walk the dog aspect of this. You know, the good old Rapala floating minnow here, one of the things, it dives a little bit under the surface, 1 to 2 feet down. You pretty much let it float back up to the surface, just kind of the erratic action that you can have with that. Different spinner baits can work here. You can go with the larger ones, kind of more of a medium size, you know, kind of a beetle spin. You know, some younger anglers might, you can, variety of fish you can catch on beetle spins. You should be surprised. You know, the attractive nature of the flash of the blade here, you know, draws in bass, crappie, variety of larger sunfish. You know, you'd be surprised. You know, you can catch a catfish on that as well. If you're going with soft plastic baits, you know, Senko worm here is a great option, 4-inch stick worm, Gary Yamamoto custom baits. You know, a lot of bass. I don't know how many thousands of bass are caught every darn day using on a Senko worm. One of the things with this, the wacky rig style, where basically ding, 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 you're twitching it through the upper part of the water column for the most part. You can let it settle back down, basically kind of keeping a tight line as possible as you're twitching that bait through the water column. And if you're just out there just primarily looking for a small bluegill, medium-sized bluegill, variety of other sunfish species, you know, basically you want to go with the bobber rig, smaller split shot. All you need is, you know, a little bit bigger than a BB shot, and you can go to a smaller bait holder hook. As I'm getting tangled up here, try to get this unwrapped. All you need is a small chunk of Nightcrawler, a little piece like that. You don't want to put too much on there. These are the smaller bait holder hooks. We have the different Aberdeen hooks as well, more of the straight shank Aberdeen hooks. And you have smaller pieces of Nightcrawler there. One of the big things when you're using the bobber rigs, try to always keep a tight line. If you don't want to have the float come floating into you and you have, you know, 6 to 8 feet of extra line and you see that bobber going down, you have a hard time setting the hook. So always try to keep a tight line on that. Another option out there, if you're fishing for catfish, as well as you can catch some sunfish on as well, using a basic Carolina rig, small egg sinker to a bead. You know, there's a glass, plastic bead here. You can use glass beads as well, more of a rattling sound, kind of slapping to the barrel swivel. Basically, that barrel swivel protects your knot from that weight constantly sliding back down. You kind of go with the 12 to 14 inches of leader to a hook there. You can put a bigger chunk of Nightcrawler on there as well. And then a lot of times with that, the fish, you'll see that fish pick up, you'll see your line ticking. As that fish is taking that bait for a ride, you'll see your line, your rod tip dancing. So, and we kind of keep a keen eye on that as you're fishing. So kind of one of those things where, you know, Nightcrawler chunks definitely can come in handy. And one, if you're out there fishing, it's always a good idea to have a pair of needle nose pliers, pair of nail clippers to help you cut the line. You know, try not to bite too much line. Your dentist will be happy with you if you're not chewing on too much fishing line. So, yeah, you know, some of the baits that we find out here, they're productive in some of the smaller fish local Virginia waters, and hopefully that'll get you out and you can catch some fish.
Thanks for tuning into this month's Fishing Report. Please comment below, let us know what questions you have about fish local Virginia, and please reference our website at the URL below to find a fish local Virginia body of water near you. We'll see you on the water.